yourself?
The one and only. Yeah. I think people are going to think that I start to write these intros.
I'm really happy there's only one of you, I can tell you.
Oh. I think that's a compliment, folks, I think.
Well,
thank you. It's lovely to see you.
You've been swimming with some sharks.
Absolutely. I spent...
I've been working with some.
Yeah. I think in television we know a few of them. Yes, I was up in Sydney. We're going to talk shiatsu this morning, but indeed a few weeks ago we may spend some time talking about this. I had a wonderful swim with the sharks in a shark pool in Sydney for about half an hour.
You're very brave.
Just extraordinary. So I have...
Very soon. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Wendy.
You're doing something very interesting this morning.
Chinese cupping.
Okay.
Chinese cupping. Now, you may... It's a hard one to answer because I suppose we're looking at how chronic the condition is, how much depth.
Time to cross to Phil Diamond.
Yeah, very well.
And you have your friend Emma here to work on this morning once again. Hi, Emma.
She's very brave.
She is indeed.
Considering what we're going to do this morning.
Well, look, I've been looking at the table. It looks a bit scary. There's something that almost looks like gunpowder over here, I'm sure.
It's not.
And quite odd this morning. Funny in the pronunciation.
Yeah, it probably sounds odd, torticollis or wry neck, but the reason I decided to do it is that I think probably everybody watching this morning has at some stage...
Well, we're sitting in strictly ball. Last is human after all. Because you have the flu.
A slight touch.
I thought you were the untouchable.
I'm trying to discover a herb that you can put under the tongue and it'll immediately give you 2 weeks holiday.
Okay.
That's what's going to cure me. So when I discover it, would you like some? Okay, it'll be going to you. What am I discussing this morning?
Actually, you were doing a very good impression of an emu a moment ago, I must say. So if you can't get your head around the liver thing, well, we can always do that. Stay after this break.
I think it's very novel. I remember one teacher years ago when I was in Dubbo High School in sixth grade called me William and I had a problem with it. But I think there's something quite charming about the way you...
Good, I mean it in the nicest possible way.
Thank you so much.
Now, we've got something this morning that everybody's going to want. Tell us what it is.
I have an idea that the phones are going to be running hot. It was important to establish a number of years ago, about the mid-80s, an accreditation board that would recognise fully qualified natural therapists.
So let's see then. How are you, Bill?
Big ask. I thought you were going to explain it and I was going to respond.
No. You've got to tell us. What is the psychology behind it?
Look, the fascinating thing about Chinese medicine, Wendy, and doctors of the day.
Pardon me, now that must be very therapeutic. He is magnificent. Bill Pearson is with us now. How are you this morning?
Oh, look, Wendy, if you ever leave Wing TV, and we hope you will never leave because we love seeing you, everybody, but will you come and write all my publicity and work for me?
Not a problem. In fact, I'm doing it now, is it?
Absolutely. Indeed.
I've got to share with everybody, which we were just chatting about. You get heaps of episodes of homicide.
Well, even going back prior to that, Division 4 and Skippy and Divorce Court.
I didn't know that about you. You were in the Divorce Court, or was that
there was a show prior to homicide called Divorce Court, which was one of the first Crawford in black and white television, all in the studio. And then, of course, we moved outside and started making homicide in Division 4 and Matlock Police. And yes, I spent many years terrorizing areas of Melbourne.
You're always a baddie, too.
And look in these eyes. And
stereotype is a baddie.
No, very good actor, not stereotype.
Okay, now we've got to make you sound convincing, is it?
Absolutely. You just blow after that wonderful intro about magnificence. You've now blown my credibility entirely.
Oh, dear. What are we talking about today?
What I'd like to look at today is the difference between a physical and a spiritual law, if you like, in relation to getting well, in relation as a person emotionally. And I mean, what do I mean by that? My body tells me it's still there. I think we've been led some big sort of world lie.
It's a bit like that, isn't it?
It must be April. It can't be the same.
It seems to have in the oldie. Thinking about touch.
Right. been hugging month. I was reading some interesting stuff the other day from the tragedy in Oklahoma City, and the medical examiner reported afterwards that the work done by massage therapists equaled, if not surpassed, hours done by psychologists and psychiatrists. Mm. Not to denigrate their professionalism, but we often forget the power of reaching out and holding, touching, hugging, the caress of care, if you like, is an extremely important one. I mean, doctors, social workers are constantly saying that touch is as important a commodity in our lives as food. Hugging month. I was reading some interesting stuff the other day from the tragedy in Oklahoma City.
They do a box of college, okay. If I look.